that time. They said, yes, that was going on. What if I was to tell you, I believe that the Holy Spirit actually allowed me to go before I showed up.
Yeah.
To make sure everything was all right, make sure I'm okay.
Yeah.
So I can do what I need to do. I was in the city.
My God.
Yeah.
Listen, there is a spirit realm that the Holy Spirit needs us to be in. And if we're going to see the miracles which God promised us that we're going to see, and we're going to do the things that the Holy Spirit promised that we're going to see, we have to be in the spirit realm. It's not going to be done by might, nor by your power, not by your schooling, not by your degrees, not because of your pedigree, not because of what church you go to, or because of your pastor.
Right.
It's not happening because you have learned to get into the spirit realm.
Yeah.
I seen something last Sunday. Was it last Sunday we took communion? Was that last Sunday? I seen something. Now, church was unusually packed last Sunday. To me, it was unusually packed. I was looking at the communion trays, because I know on a normal day we score trays and it's not that many people. Now, Bishop told people to take two and take it. Some was taking three.
That's right.
And normally, it's just enough for the normal. Now, folks are taking double. And nobody noticed that it never ran out. Because it was the supernatural. This is what Jesus was trying to tell his disciples. He said, listen, you are in the spirit. I will touch everything that you have and make sure that it never runs out. Jesus did the same thing. He fed 5,000, then he fed 4,000, and the Bible says in Mark chapter 4, it says that after they fed the 5,000, then the 4,000, the Bible says, then the disciples start to argue about, hey, we're not going to have enough for lunch. And Jesus said, what is wrong with y'all? Can y'all see what I already did?
Yeah. Yeah.
Why don't you understand what happened in the spirit? That you don't ever have to have enough in the natural. Your supply is from the spirit.
Yeah.
And you'll have everything you need in the spirit realm.
That's it.
The Bible tells us that we can go and buy with no money.
Yeah.
How do you buy with no money?
Come on.
You do it in the spirit.
Come on.
You can go buy, go in the spirit, go buy a car. And somebody call you and tell you, come pick it up. You can buy a house in the spirit. And someone call you and say, oh, I got this house for you. And what happens is you are forcing God to try to be natural like you. So you want to see a sign in the natural, and the Holy Spirit is saying, I'm showing you the sign, but you can't see because you won't get the spirit.
Okay.
Yes, yes.
Okay, I'm going to say this, and I'm done.
Come on, prophet.
When you move in the spirit realm, the rules are different.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Than in the earth realm. See, in the earth realm, they say if you do the same thing over and over and expect different results, that's insanity.
Yeah.
In the spirit realm, you do the same thing over and over and something new is going to pop up.
Mm-hmm.
It's called being consistent.
Yeah.
Persistence. In the spirit realm, you can be praying for the same child over and over and over and over and over and over again, and they can still be doing the same exact thing. But in the spirit realm, when you continue doing something like that, it creates a moratorium for God. And God then, when he's looking at you, he sees this memorial that you built up, and then he acts and he moves on.
Yes.
In the spirit realm, you are not subject to the same thing that you're subject to in the natural realm.
Yeah.
In the natural realm, you might can't get the job because you don't have credentials. But in the spirit realm, you're qualified. And so if you move in the spirit, you can have it.
Amen.
Okay. I went to a service not too long ago, and I was wearing some type of African type clothing, right? I'm on the service. The Holy Spirit told me before I got there, the Holy Spirit said that you came here for an assignment. And I understood that when I walked in the room, I could feel that I shifted the room. I understood that, you know, my anointing on my life was so heavy that I was kind of outranking most of the people in the room. So I walked into the room, And they wanted us to make us move, and we was moving around and all this stuff. And these young people were screaming and hollering, and they were trying to pray. And I say trying to because there is a right and a wrong way to pray.
Amen.
If it wasn't, they would have said, Jesus, teach us how to pray the same way John taught these people how to pray. And Jesus said, and this is how you pray. So there's a right and a wrong way.
Right.
So they were praying, just making, doing stuff. And so I sat there, and I felt the presence of God so heavy because the Spirit wanted to actually prophesy in the service. They were so religious, they didn't understand what prophecy was. And so they were fighting it. So next thing you know, the Holy Spirit says, Cedric, you know they think you're a witch. And you know, I tell myself, stop asking the Holy Spirit like you don't know. I said, me? You see, yes, they think you're a witch. So next thing you know, all of these prayers start to change. And they begin to pray against witches and warlocks. And they begin to pray against spirits from Africa, from West Africa. And they begin, I mean, they're real heavy. They begin to even rally kind of like around me, trying to rebuke God.
Wow.
So I said, Holy Spirit, why is this happening? He said, because they're so religious and because they're so in their flesh that anytime someone who has access to the spirit realm shows up, it scares them so bad, they call it the devil.
Right.
All right.
And he said, now this is what I want you to do. He said, there's three of them that figure the devil, and I want you to prophesy to all three. I said, Lord, that's going to really scare me. I said, Lord, and they have these candles burning and stuff. I said, Lord, they call me the devil. No. I told the Lord, I said, Lord, if they put their hands on me, let me lay everybody out and blow out the candles. That's what they do. So I went to go prophesy to the young lady. I said, young lady, so she's terrified. So she's had to touch her. I said, calm down. I said, God's been speaking to you. I said, there's some things that God has been trying to show you. And I said, you know, you have this black journal with the spiral thing on it, and it has green writing on it, and use a green pen to write in it. Tears just begin to fall out her face. She pulls out this notebook and this pen that I'm prophesying her about, and she starts to write what I say. So I begin to give her the answer that she had been asking God for. And I said, what's sad is because you were so afraid of the spirit, you almost missed it.
Mm.
You were so afraid of the spirit, you almost missed it. And she cried, and she said, thank you so much. And then the other young lady, I went to her and I began to say what thus said the Lord. And I, when I got done prophesying her, she was terrified. And so she said, well, what is your name? I said, I'm Prophet Cedric. She was like, oh, you're Prophet Cedric. And what's interesting is she was so scared of the prophetic and so scared of the anointing and the mantle of my life that she literally thought I was a witch. Because I'm able to move in the spirit, and there's a level of spirit that I bring with me.
Uh-huh.
I'm saying this for a reason. Because there's going to be some young people. There's going to be some people that God's going to use you to do things that you have never even
Amen.
Considered.
Amen.
And when it happens, you don't be afraid because, yes, they're going to say crazy stuff about you. They're going to say all types of stuff. They may even call you Beelzebub like they did Jesus. They may call you a devil. They may call you a witch. And I'm prophesying right now to this house that there are going to be some crazy things that are going to happen.
Come on, yeah.
I need you to start to keep your cell phones on because when they call you in the middle of the night and tell you sister so-and-so died, you're not going to go pray, but you're going to go and lay hands and you're going to see her rise up from her dead bed. I'm talking about, they're going to call you and say, my house is about to be repossessed. And you said, no, it's not. I need you to go to the ATM on the fifth corner around on this
All
block
right.
where you put your car in. Natural is coming to this house in a way we've never where you can speak to him before he gets pulled over. Because you pick up in your spirit that he might go this way and say, son, don't even go down that block. Because the police that's going to be waiting for you. And you can stop it from there. Listen, you have the greatest advantage. Because if you move in the spirit realm, stop trying to handle your issues only on the natural. You are a dual being. You are both natural and spiritual. Why don't you start doing it in the spirit realm?
Yes. Yes.
I've seen so many miracles happening here, and I've literally seen this. I've seen a line here going out of the church and on the sidewalk near the parking lot of people waiting for miracles. Wow. I see everybody laying hands, moving doors like a line, like an assembly line of miracles.
Oh, yes, Lord.
Do you know that he wants to use us that way?
Yes.
If we will be in the spirit.
Woo. Thank you, Jesus.
I'm talking about the spirit realm.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
I'm talking about where it's not a miracle, and it's not a crazy thing for you to see an angel.
Yes.
To see them assisting you. The Bible says that the angels are our health minister. They help you fulfill whatever your divine assignment here in this realm is.
Yes.
Use it. We have the stuff. We have the tool. If you are defeated in this season, it's your own fault.
Yes, Lord.
We can do these things. So he said, oh, mountain, what are you before us in the bed? Oh, sickness, oh, whatever it is. What is it towards us because we know how to move in the spirit realm? It's nothing. I want to do this, and I'm done. But I believe that there's some people here who really want to go into the spirit and be able to move and operate in the spirit. I believe there's some things that God wants for us to do that we have to do in the spirit.
Amen.
I hear this in my spirit. It's somebody praying. Who has HIV, and I hear it in my spirit that as you lay hands on them, that God's going to heal them.
Jesus.
And tell them to go get tested again, and when they get tested, they'll show proof that they've been healed. Okay. I hear that. We get scared of stuff. We don't realize that we can. I'm going to share last story, but I want to do this because I want to activate us in the spirit. They just play something in there. I remember planning this meeting, and we spent tons of money on this meeting. And I was about 21 years old, and I called it the Lighthouse Prayer Ministries. And the Lord showed me all these people being healed and all this stuff happening. We rented out this big old church, and it could fit about 1,500 people in. We did some radio ads and flyers and everything. So the night of the event, we get there to the church and the brother being set up. And while I was there, the musician called and said he wasn't coming. The praise team called, told me they weren't coming. And I got so many calls from pastors and stuff that said we're not coming. And it ended up being me, my mom, my brother, and four other people in this huge room. And so I began to cry and I said, God, I failed. He said, no, I told you to have this service. And I said, Lord, I failed. I heard you wrong. He said, no, I told you to have this service. I said, well, what do you want me to do? Nobody's here but my mom, my brother, and a few other people. He said, I want you to preach. He said, but I want you to preach as if the room was full.
All right.
So I began to preach, and back then I used to do a lot of hollering. And I preached. I was sweating. I preached as hard as I could. And while I was preaching, a lady and her two daughters walked in, and when they walked in, they were already crying. And I began to prophesy to them, and the Lord showed me that the young lady had HIV. And I said, I need to ask you something. I said, why couldn't you get into the service? And she whispered to me and told me. And the Holy Spirit said, give her this towel. I tell her to sleep on this towel for 7 days. I gave her the towel. I said, here, I said, this is really nasty to me. I think it's nasty. I don't know why he's telling me to do this. I said, but the Lord wants you to lay on this towel for 7 days. I said, don't wash it. Lay on it for 7 days. And God's going to heal your body. That young lady began to cry. She said, I told the Lord that I was going to kill myself this night. She said, unless he showed me that he was real. She said, but I didn't hold up with service. She said, I pray that will nobody be there but me and God. Supernaturally. Come on, begin to ask him.